New non-invasive sticker is helping with early detection of skin cancer. Heather Lake, live in Kearney Mesa now with a look at this. Fascinating, Heather.
Yeah, I know. When I first heard about this, I said, no way. And then you watch the video of how it works, and I just had to show everyone at home. So here we are, right in Kearney Mesa. I'm going to show you this. We've got the vice president of the American Society of Dermatology, right? Okay, the Academy of Dermatology, Dr. Neal Bhatia. And we are going to explain how this sticker works. A little clear sticker, but it can tell you so much. So you're going to show us the sticker and how it works on a patient here.
Yeah, I mean, this has really helped a lot with reducing procedures sometimes when patients have a mole in the wrong spot, for example, like on her eyebrow, or if we got someone who's not a good candidate. These adhesive patches of it, I have actually some genomic information on it that'll help us to predict the need to maybe take this mole off, for example, or just to follow it clinically.
Okay. I know a lot of people, we love our vitamin D, we love our sunshine in San Diego, and sometimes we just don't know. Is that a freckle or is there something wrong going on there? And this you can do at home or in your doctor's office?
Absolutely. Well, during the pandemic, we were able to send these out to patients and help them supervise it over the phone or on camera. But we really want to do these in person because, you know, these are really 3D problems. They're not a 2D problem. And telemedicine won't help us to diagnose it by texture or look. But at the same time, these patches, we can apply over here, for example, and we just circle the mole right underneath it.
So it's a patch. It's not just a clear sticker. There's a lot of things going on
Absolutely.
In that sticker.
And, you know, these patches, when they send them to the lab, they'll get the information and the proteins from the mole that will tell us under the microscope or underneath the lab set if there's anything atypical that would lead to melanoma or at least be something that we have to watch a little bit more closely.
So then every year you could kind of do that same process and see what's going on. So then you don't have a lot of, you know, cuts and nicks and marks all over your body.
That's
as
right.
many of us as we age, we get different freckles, different moles, whatever it is.
Absolutely. You think about a patient with a mole, like right in the décolleté, for example, on the face, mm-hmm. a younger kid who's a little afraid of needles. This at least gives us an option. Now, it's not, again, an alternative to surgery because some moles definitely need to be cut out.
Uh-huh.
But at the same time, we want to make sure we're doing what we need to do to get the best information first, and then that'll tell us. What
how many of those do you have to send out for the one mole to, like, you know, to find out what's going on there?
So this is a set of four. It's
okay.
looking for two specific sets of proteins.
Okay.
And then those proteins light up on a report, whether they're positive or negative. And the more advanced or atypical the mole is, the more proteins will light up, and then that'll give us some information about what to do next.
Yeah, I know that a lot of us all are worried about being in the sun now. We think a lot more about it than we did when we were kids. I think about it more in my 30s than I did in my 20s.
Oh, absolutely.
You have kids at home.
Yep.
Can you give me, like, what sunscreen do you put on your kids? As the person who is the vice president of the Academy of Dermatology, I want to know what sunscreen you put on your kids, and
Absolutely.
I'm going to buy it today.
Absolutely. So you always want to look for a sunscreen that covers vitamin A and, UVA and UVB, because
mm-hmm.
UVA is what makes you dark, mm-hmm. right, and gets you skin cancer. UVB makes you red and sunburn. And a good, you know, sunscreen about 15. There are some nice mineral sunscreens, some nice chemical ones that are still pretty good that won't give you any trouble. And, you know, you want to make sure you get a good spray sunscreen for the backs and legs, covering surface area, kind of like bug spray, but getting good surface area covered.
I have heard that really pale children like my own and myself, that we can actually end up getting, because you lay out, you know, and you kind of, I'm going to take a little sunbathe moment. I'm going to lay on my stomach. We can actually get skin cancer on the bottom of our feet.
Absolutely. Bob Marley died of melanoma on his foot between his toes, which is very scary. And he's dark, right? Even
That's
more
something
so,
new every day.
Exactly.
I did not know that. Okay.
Well, even more about what you said about vitamin D, there's a big myth about vitamin D because you're getting a lot from your diet anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And the vitamin D that you're getting from the sun is actually not as absorbed as well from your diet.
Oh, yeah. You have to run around naked,
exactly.
right? And then we don't really do that very often.
Right. The other thing people forget is you're getting the same sun in the car as you are at the beach.
Okay.
So people still have to wear sunscreen twice a day, backs of the hands, and like you said, on the extremities.
Oh, yeah, when you're driving, for sure. Before we go back to the studio, what is this called? Do we order it? How do we get
this
it?
This is the DermTech assay. You
okay.
can get it at any dermatologist's office just by requesting it, but also you really need to do this in cooperation with your dermatologist to make sure the right nevi, the right moles are getting tested,
mm-hmm.
making sure you're getting a good head-to-toe exam every year, and what we call the ABCD criteria, looking at asymmetry, color, border, and the diameters of the moles, as well as anything that's changing.
Okay.
And you also want to make sure that these tests are being done by the right dermatologist who knows the technique, because the wrong, you know, mole, for example, if it's sent in, you're not going to get the right information.
So interesting. I could talk to you about this for the next hour. They're telling me to wrap up, so I will send it back. Can you ask Raul, ask Chrissy, because she said something in the beginning of the show,
right,
that the UV today index was very, very high and that you could get burned in like a certain amount of minutes. And
ooh,
I'm curious to see
Chrissy,
what it was
today,
to remind
today
all of us at home while we're talking about it.
It's a 10, and you can get a sunburn in less than 15 minutes.
Boom.
Oh.
That's fast.
So put on that sunblock. Make your kids look like little ghosts as they walk out.
Good advice. Lotion up. That's why I tell the kids, why are you little? Lotion up. Heather, thank you.